Ladies and gentlemen, now sit back and do not relax. Sit on the edge of your seat, laugh out loud, cheer, and enjoy your afternoon. A terrific time with a story preferred by 9 out of 10 dentists. Primary Community Education presents, under the direction of Nicole Matfeld, Little Shop of Horrors.
On the 21st day of the month of September, in an early year of a decade not too long before our own, the human race suddenly encountered a deadly threat to its very existence. This terrifying enemy surfaced, as such enemies often do, in the seemingly most innocent and unlikely of places.
So, look who decides to come to life.
Good morning, Mr. Mushnick.
What morning? It's 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Not that we have any customers. Who has customers when you run a flower shop on Skid Row?
I'm sorry.
Prelboard, what's going on back there?
Very little, Mr. Mushnick.
Audrey, you better go see what... Audrey, where did you get that shiner?
A shiner?
That greasy boyfriend of yours has been beating up on you again. Audrey, it's none of my business. But I'm beginning to think maybe he's not such a nice boy.
Well, you don't meet nice boys when you live on Skid Row, Mr.
Mushnick. I got these pleasure products, Mr.
Seymour, look what you've done to the inventory.
Oh, don't yell at Seymour, Mr. Mushnick.
Well, hi, Audrey. You look radiant today. Samuel, I make up.
Well, I'll clean it up before any of the customers get here.
Well, that ought to give you plenty of time. Look, God, what an existence I got. Misfit employees, bums on the sidewalk, businesses lousy. My life is a living hell. You, urchins, off the stoop. It ain't bad enough. I got some winos permanently decorating the storefront. I need you worthless ragamuffins to complete the picture.
Oh, we ain't bothering nobody. Are we, Crystal?
No, we ain't, Renette.
You ought to be in school.
We're on the split shift.
Right, we went to school up until the 5th grade, then we split.
How do you intend to better yourselves?
Better? Ourselves. Mister, when you're from Skid Row, ain't no such thing.
Put in your hours, all the hours that have always
5 o'clock is even worse.
Downtown, where the guys are dripped.
Downtown,
where they rip your slip.
Downtown,
where relationships are not
down. Down on Skid Row.
Tells me, gee, I'm not sure. Sweep that floor, kiddo. I started life as an orphan, a child in the street, here on Skid Row. He took me in, gave me shelter, a bed, crust of bread and a job. Treats me like dirt, calls me a slob, which I am. Constantly pray, I'll get out of here. Please won't somebody say, I'll get out of here. Someone give me my shot, or I'll rot here. Show me how and I will, I'll get out of here. I'll start climbing uphill and get out of here. Please won't somebody say, I'll get out of here. Someone give me my shot, or I'll rot here. Move in a new direction.
What Zim was trying to say, Mr. Mushnick, is what we were talking about it and we both agree. Zim, why don't you run in the back and grab that strange, interesting plant you're working on? You see, Mr. Mushnick, some of those exotic plants Zim's been tinkering around with are really unusual. And we were thinking some of those strange and interesting plants prominently displayed and advertised, it would attract business.
I'm afraid she's not looking very well today.
There. Now, isn't that bizarre?
At least. Seymour, what kind of a weirdo plant is that?
I don't know, it looks like some kind of fly trap, but I haven't been able to identify it in any of my books. So I gave it my own name. Yadri 2.
After me?
Oh, I hope you don't mind. Look. If you put a strange and interesting plant like this here in the window, maybe...
Maybe what? Do you have any idea how ridiculous you sound? Just because you put a strange and interesting plant in the window, people don't just suddenly...
Excuse me! I couldn't help but notice that strange and interesting plant. What is it?
It's an Audrey, too.
I've never seen anything like it before.
No one has.
Where did you get it?
Well, you remember that total eclipse of the sun a couple weeks ago? I was walking in the wholesale flower district one day. I passed by this shop where this old Chinese man. He sometimes sells me weird and exotic cuttings. Because he sees, you know, well, strange plants have a hobby. But there was really nothing unusual there that day, so. You know, I was about to just walk on by. But then suddenly, and without warning, there was this total eclipse of the sun. And it got very dark. And there was a strange humming sound, like from another world. And when light came back, she was just sitting there. No, just stuck in amongst the zinnias. Could have sworn it hadn't been there before, but the old Chinese man sold it to me anyway for $1.95.
Well, that is an unusual story and a fascinating plant. Oh, I may as well take $50 worth of roses while I'm here.
$50? Yes, sir, right away, sir.
Can you break $100?
I close the till for the day.
Well, I'll just have to take twice as many then, won't I?
Twice as many? Yes, sir, right away, sir. Audrey, my darling, please fetch this gentleman $100 worth of our very finest red American beauty roses.
Why, thank you. Yes, sir, that is one strange and interesting plant.
Well, don't just stand there. Quick, put that plant, what do you call it?
The Audrey 2.
The Audrey 2, put it back in the window so passers-by can see. Oh, my God, I never would have believed. My children, we're all going to dinner.
Oh, I'd love to, Mr. Mushnick, but I have a date.
Oh, Audrey, would that say no good, Nick? Him, you don't need a date. You need major medical. He's not a good, clean kind of boy.
He's a professional.
What kind of a professional rides a motorcycle and wears a black leather jacket?
He's a rebel, Mr. Mushnick, but he makes good money. And besides, he's the only fellow I've got. Enjoy dinner. Good night, Seymour.
Good night.
Poor girl.
Well, are we still going to dinner?
You're not going anywhere, Crowboy. You're staying right here and taking care of that sick plant. Why does it keep fainting all the time?
I told you I don't know. The Audrey 2 is not a healthy girl.
Well, strictly between us, neither is the Audrey 1.
If only I knew what breed it was, what genus, but I can't find it in any of my books.
Well, my advice to you, Crowboy, is you better figure it out and fast. Look what this exotic little beauty did for business.
I know.
So, nurse this plant back to health, Seymour. I'm counting on you.
I know.
You do?
I do.
So fix. Good night.
Aw, Tui. Mr. Mushnick and Archie just met you, but we've been going through this for weeks. Growing wilt, spurt and flop by your sickly little plant, or just plain stubborn. What is it you want? What is it you need? Sunshine, I've given you dirt. You've given me nothing but heartache and hurt. I'm begging you sweetly, I'm down on my knees. Oh, please, grow for me. I've given you plant food and water to sip. I've given you potash. You've given me zip. Oh God, how I missed you. Oh God, how you tease. Oh please, grow for me. I've given you southern exposure to get you to thrive. I pinch you back hard like I'm supposed to. You're barely alive. I've tried you at levels of moisture from desert to mud. I've given you glow lights and mineral supplements. What do you want from me for? Ouch! Damn thorns! Damn roses. Clumsy me. Hey, Tui, look what I did. Hey! Tui, you opened up! Hey, wonder what made you do that? Oh, I think I know what made you do that. Look, maybe I can spare a few drops as long as you don't make a habit out of her leaving. I've given you sunlight. I've given you rain. Looks like you're not happy. Plus I open a vein. I'll give you a few drops, if that'll appease. Now please, oh please, throw for me.
We conclude our interview with Mr. Seymour Krellhorn, the young botanical. Do you mind if I call you a genius?
Gosh, no!
The genius has developed a new breed of plant life, hitherto unknown to this planet, the Audrey 2. Now, Mr. Krellhorn, I just have one last question for you. Do you need anything special?
Special? No, it's a secret formula, but not hard to come by.
I see. Well,
I'd like to remind the listeners that the Audrey 2 is exclusively on display at Bushnick Skid Row floors, open 6 days a week, 10 to 6.
The address! The address! Mention the address! Oh, well, it's still great advertising. I can't believe it. Couldn't be happening. Pitch me goils. Couldn't be happening. All of a sudden, success coming out of the blue. I put a sign up right in the front window, an advertisement right in the front window. Stop in and see the amazing new plant, Audrey 2. And the really remarkable thing is that people, they do. Seymour, that twerp of a klutz, finally did something right. Audrey 2 drives him nuts. What a blessing this wonderful plant should exist. And should rake in the bucks for me hand over fist.
Hello, how'd I do?
What's great, Seymour?
You sounded sexier than the Wolfman.
But the address of the shop. How many times have I told you?
I'm sorry, I was nervous. Hey, where's Audrey? She said she'd be here.
Forget about Audrey. I've got three more radio interviews lined up tomorrow, and the Skid Row Herald Examiner wants a picture.
If I had a mother, she'd be so happy.
You're an overnight sensation, Seymour.
Who'd have believed it?
One day he pushed a broom, nothing in his news but gloom and doom. Then he lit a fuse and give him room. Stand aside and watch them blow. Explosion make the boom. Don't it go to shore, you never know.
Seymour was in a funk. He was number zero, who'd have thunk? He'd become a hero, just a punk. He was a forgotten so-and-so. Then one day,
crash kerplunk.
Tony got a show, you never know.
Thank you.
sure did.
Seymour's first radio broadcast. I wanted to be here to cheer him on. I tried to be on time, but...
Don't tell me.
You got tied up.
Oh, no, just handcuffed a little.
Girl, I don't know who this mess is you've been hanging out with, but he is hazardous to your health.
Well, that's for sure, but I can't leave him.
Why not?
Well, he'd get angry. And if he does this to me when he likes me, imagine what would happen if he ever got mad.
Don't dump the chump. Get a new guy and let him protect you.
And we got one all picked out.
A little botanical genius. And she ain't talking about George Washington Carver.
Seymour?
Bingo.
Oh, no. We're just friends. I could never be Seymour's girl. I've got a past.
Who doesn't?
I don't even deserve a sweet, considerate, suddenly successful guy like Seymour.
Sounds like this child suffers from a low self-image.
You have a point.
She has a problem.
I know Seymour is the greatest. But I'm dating a semi-sadist. So I got a black eye, my arms in a chair. Still, that Seymour's a cutie. Well, if not, he's not in that beauty. And I dream of a place where we can be together at last.
And what kind of place is that? An emergency room?
Oh, no. Just a daydream I have. A little development I dream of just off the interstate. Not fancy like Levitt Town, just a little street in a little suburb, far, far from urban Skid Row. The sweetest and greenest place, where everybody has the same lawn out front and the same little flagstone patio out back. And all the houses are so neat and pretty, because they all look just alike. I dream of it all the time, just me and my toaster, and a sweet little guy like Seymour. A matchbox of our own. A fence of real chain link. A grill out along the patio. Disposal. I dream we'll go.
been booming. We need refrigeration in our human crib display, so we're closed for renovation today.
Yes, indeed. This is the shop you heard about on the news. The Audrey 2's on display. Stores in media.
We're closed for decoration, cause fortune has been smiling. So now we're due for painting, new plumbing and retiling. We'll make our ships into a place of our little shop, and then tomorrow we'll be open again.
Seymour, aren't you finished yet?
I'm doing my best for all these families to make it turn around.
You have been getting hurt so much lately.
We're closed for renovation, for swabbing, now improving. The business has been thriving, since our beach has been blooming. The phones have not stopped ringing with the customers who say, and now they're about to peonies.
Another dozen babies, please.
Geraniums, anemones.
Forget me not, floralies.
With gratis home deliveries.
I'll pay the COVID COPs. We're closed for renovation.
Enormous family, and they're dropping out like flies. Seymour, if we lose that business over this, you are finished!
You know, sometimes I think Mr. Mushnick is too hard on you.
Oh, I don't mind. I mean, after all, he gave me everything I got. He took me out of the Skid Row home for boys when I was just a little tight. Gave me a nice warm place to sleep under the counter. Good things to eat, like meatloaf and water. Floors to sweep and toilets to clean and every other Sunday off.
I think you ought to raise your expectations, Seymour. Well, now that you're becoming successful, I mean. Why don't you start with some new clothes? No offense, but with all the photo sessions and interviews, a new experimental botanist has to look the part.
That's a very bad shop, Audrey. I don't have good taste like you.
Well, I could help you pick things out.
You could?
Sure.
You'd go shopping with me?
Sure.
You'd be seen in a public place such as a department store with me?
Sure.
Tonight?
Oh, well, I can't tonight. I've got a date, but I would like to go with you another time.
Yeah, sure, I'll pencil you in.
Yeah, I bet you got a lot of dates now, huh?
Not dates exactly, but a lot of garden clubs have been calling asking me to give lectures.
Gee!
Yeah, imagine me giving lectures. I mean, I didn't even finish grade school.
Oh, well, that doesn't matter. You have life experience.
Yeah, some experience. I mean, I don't even know what it's like to fly in an airplane.
Me neither.
Or eat a fancy dinner at Howard Johnson's.
Me neither.
Or riding a motorcycle.
Oh. Well, that's no big deal. And besides, it's dangerous.
It is?
Extremely dangerous. Oh, geez, that reminds me. I gotta go fix my face. My date will be here any minute.
Excuse me, ladies. Which way to 1313 Skid Row?
I'm afraid that information will cost you a dollar.
Hey, no problem. Here you go.
It's right over there. But if you're like the thousands of others flocking down to see the Audrey 2, you better come back tomorrow, ma'am. The shop is closed today.
Oh, I'm not here to shop, ladies. I'm here to pick up my date.
Your date? You aren't by any chance talking about a girl with a black eye, are you? And several other medical issues.
Well, as a matter of fact,
oh,
I...
Oh, yeah! Hey, that's a girl.
Ladies, please. I'm friendly. Nitrous oxide.
Why don't you get lost, by talisman? We don't need more of your kind around here.
My kind is a very nice kind, ladies. I'm not a monster.
What else would you call it?
I would call it an occupational hazard.
What?
You see, ladies, my line of work requires a certain fascination with human pain and suffering. This stuff is great. Allow me to explain. When I was younger, just a bad little kid, my mama noticed funny things I did, like shooting puppets with a BB gun. I poisoned guppies, and when I was done, I'd find a pussycat and bash in its head. That's what my mama said.
What did she say?
She said, my boy, I think someday you'll find a way to meet your natural tendencies. Hey, you'll be a dentist.
You'll
have a challenge for causing things. Hey, be a dentist. Oh, we'll pay you to be inhumane.
Inhumane?
Your temperament's wrong for the priesthood. Teaching would suit you still less. So be a dentist. You'll be a success.
The leader of the
flack. One stuck up that gas. Oh my god!
The dentist said he'll never be any good.
Who wants a teeth done by the Marquis de Sade?
Oh, that hurts! I got no!
Ah, shut up. Open wide. Here I come. I am your dentist. And I enjoy the career that I picked.
Muppet.
I am your dentist. I get off on the pain I inflict.
Really love it.
When I start extracting your molars, you girls will be screaming like holy rollers. And though it may cause my patients distress, somewhere in heaven above me, I know that my mama's proud of me. Cause I'm a dentist. That must be that new plant they've been talking about in the news. What do you call it?
Yatri 2.
Cute name. Catchy. Nice plant. Big.
Well, thanks. I raised it myself. Now, really, you should be going.
Oh, it's okay, Seymour. This is my boyfriend, Seymour. Orin Screwfellow. DGS.
That's better. Now, you say you raise this thing, right, kid?
Right.
Well, if I were you, I sure as hell wouldn't keep it down in a barrel in a skid row dump like this. This avocado could be a ticket to the stop. You could take it to any florist shop in town and name your price. Hell, somebody make you a damn partner to get their hands on this.
I don't care. I mean, I'm happy here.
He was very loyal.
Somebody talking to you?
Oh, no. Excuse me.
Excuse me what?
Excuse me, doctor.
That's better. No, I'm telling you, kid. This thing's a big green gold mine. Get your ass out of this dump and take the plant with you.
What?
Mushnik Skid Row Floors. It's like a joke. Do you hear me talking?
Yeah, I hear you.
Shouldn't
we be leaving now? Oh, excuse me.
Excuse me, what?
Excuse me, doctor, doctor. Excuse me, doctor.
Gotta train him, Asta. Well, my bike's outside in double park, but you think about what I said, you hear me? Think about it.
Yeah, sure, I'll think about it.
You'll think about it?
Audrey, got the handcuffs?
Yeah, they're right in my bag.
Let's go.
You think about it.
you think about it.
Well, I don't like that guy, Mr. Mushnick, and you should hear the way he talks to Archie.
God in heaven know the kid just said he'd mull it over.
No wonder she looks so unhealthy, it's enough to make you sick.
If he left me, if Seymour left me.
Sweet and good and beautiful as she is, she deserves a princess to just a creep like him.
Close to bankrupt.
What a louse.
Beset, befuddled, and bereft. That's what I'd be if Seymour left.
He's a disgrace to the dental profession.
Seymour!
Sir?
Seymour! Would you like to be my son? Would you like to be my own adopted boy? I never liked him much before, the counting cash, it's in the drawer, much too broke, I've got no choice, so yes!
What more?
I want to be your dad. I hope to see you climbing up my family tree. I used to think you left a stench, but now I see that you're a mensch, and I'm proposing to be my son. Mushnick and Son, sounds great. Three words with the ring of fate. Please sail this foray with me. A glorious dream come true. Mushnick and his fortune, you! What business will do for FTP? How about it, Seymour, be my son? Say the word, I'll have my lawyer on the phone.
Now, Mr. Mushnick, don't be rash. You always said that I was
tricked. Oh, I was joking.
Sir, I'm joking.
It's a physical expression of my pride, of the sweet paternal Michigas I've held bent up inside. So?
Well, you?
Go ahead and say it, Seymour. Tell me that you will.
Gee, I'd really like to, but...
I'll hold my breath until...
Someday, when I own this whole shop,
I'll remember I owe it to you. Ah, Tooey. Who cares if I've been a little on the anemic side these past few weeks? Who cares if I've had a few dizzy spells and lightheadedness? Well, it's been worth it, old pal. Well, I'm getting kind of hungry. I think I'm going to come down to Schmendrick's, so I'll see you in the, Oh, boy. Here we go again. Look, I haven't got much left. Just give me a few more days to heal, and then we can start again on the left hand. I beg your pardon? Tooey, you talked to you opened up your trap, you think you said?
Feed me, Crowborn, feed me now.
I can't.
I'm starving.
I know, but you, look, maybe I can squeeze a little.
I need some food.
I know, you can't get blood from me, you just.
More.
Well, I haven't got any more. What do you want me to do, slit my wrists? Look, how about I run down to the corner and pick you up a pound of rare roast beef, eh?
Must be blood.
Tooey, that's disgusting.
Must be fresh.
I don't want to hear this.
Feed me.
Does it have to be human?
Feed me.
Does it have to be mine?
Feed me.
Where am I supposed to get it?
Feed me, Seymour. Feed me all night long. That's right, boy. You can do it. Feed me, Seymour. Feed me all night long. 'Cause if you feed me, Seymour, I can grow up big and strong.
Look, you eat blood, I can too. Let's face it, how am I supposed to keep on fading you? Kill people?
I'll make it worth your while.
What?
You think this is all coincidence, baby? The sudden success around here? Your adoption papers?
Look, you're a plant, an inanimate object.
Does this look inanimate to you, punk? If I can talk and I can move, who's to say I can't do anything I want?
Like what?
Like living, pal. Like so you get everything to secret, greasy, heart desires. Would you like a Cadillac car? Or a guest shot on Jack Bar? I don't want a date with Teddy Lamar. You're gonna get it.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
How'd you like to be a big wheel? Driving down for every meal. I'm the plan who can make it all real. You're gonna get it.
You're gonna get it.
I'm your genie. I'm your friend. I'm your willing slave. Take the chance, just feed me, and you know the kind of eats, the kind of red hot treats, the kind of sticky, licky sweets I crave. Come on, Seymour, don't be a butt. Trust me in your life, and surely rob a king cut. Show a little initiative, work up the guts, and you'll get it.
I don't know.
Until you met me. Come on, kid. What'll it be? Money? Girls? One particular girl? How about that Audrey? Think it over. There must be someone you can 86. Real quiet like. Give me some lunch. How about a room at the Ritz? Wrapped in velvet, covered in glitz. A little nookie gonna clean up your zits and you'll get it.
I'd like
to hide my
jeans.
Now you're
going around like I was JT.
Yeah.
Picking all the guys on the corner turn green.
So go get it. If you wanna be profound, if you really gotta justify, take a breath and look around. A lot of folks deserve to die.
Hey, hold. Now hold on a second. That's not a very nice thing to say. No, I don't know anybody who deserves to get chopped up and fed to a hungry plant.
Sure you do.
stupid woman with a friggin' scatterbrain.
I'm sorry, Doctor.
Get in there and pick up the damn sweater, you dizzy cow.
Oh, Doctor, right away, Doctor. They see more than my sweater in here before.
Your friggin' head went screwed on.
Warren, that hurt.
Move it.
If you are harassing out, leave the very hard seat. Stop and think it over. The God's soul is like when moved me. The God's soul is like when moved me. The God's soul is like when moved me.
So nasty, treating her rough.
Smacking her around and always talking so tough.
You need blood, he's got more than enough.
I need blood and he's got more than enough. So go get it!
Next.
I guess that's me, Dr. Scrivello.
Do you have an appointment?
We met yesterday, Seymour Crowborn.
Right, the guy with the plant.
Right.
And the band-aids.
Right.
And the gun?
Right.
Why are you pointing a gun at me, Seymour?
Somebody
a little nervous about seeing the dentist?
No, I'm not nervous.
Oh, it'll only hurt a little.
No, you don't understand. I don't want my teeth examined.
Of course you want your teeth examined. Say
No!
Say We'll start with that wisdom,
no.
Oh, we'll just rip the bugger out of there. What do you say?
No, I gotta get out of here.
Well, there's always time for dental hygiene, Seymour. Have you ever seen the results of a neglected mouth? This could be you.
It could?
Unless I take immediate action.
Well, you gonna use Novocaine?
What for? Dulls the senses.
But it'll hurt.
Only till you pass out.
What's that?
That's the drill, Seymour.
But it's rusty.
It's an antique. They don't make weapons, instruments like this anymore. Sturdy, heavy, dull. This is gonna be a challenge. This is gonna be a pleasure. I'm gonna want some gas for this one.
Gas?
Nitrous oxide, Seymour.
Oh, thank God, I thought you weren't gonna use any.
Oh, Seymour, the gas isn't for you. It's for me. That's right, I wanna really enjoy this. And I find that a little bit of giggle gas before we begin increases my pleasure enormously. So just relax, Seymour! I'll be with you in a moment.
Now, do it now! While he's guessing himself to a palpable stupor, the timing's ideal and the moment is super too ready and fire and blow the thing faster away! Now, do it now! Just a flicker of pressure right here on the trigger, and Audrey won't have to put up with that pig for another day. Now for the girl, now for the plant, now yes I will, but I can't.
Oh boy, Seymour, I'm really flying now. Oh, the things we're gonna do to your mouth. Well, I guess I've had about enough of this stuff. I'll just take the mask off and... Seymour, guess what?
What?
It's stuck.
What?
The mask is stuck. I can't get it off. I can asphyxiate in here. Seymour, give me a hand, will you?
Well, he says, well, Seymour, don't be fooled if I should giggle like a sappy, happy dope. It's just the gas. It's got me high, but don't let that back deceive you any moment I could die. Though I giggle and I chortle, bear in mind I'm not immortal. Why this little thing strikes me funny, I don't know. Cause it really is a rock way to go.
What we have here is an ethical dilemma. Less I help with the mask, I can go for like a bear. Couldn't chew when I tried, get the picture on my side. I could offer guy was staying in the chair. What we have here is a tricky moral problem. Do I help with the last?
Seven.
7,000 lutneas, panaceas, or the yellow roses?
Please, I've only got 2 years allergic to chrysanthemums.
Well, holly hearts are hardy air. Which ones would your wife prefer?
Wait, I'm sorry, sir. 1 minute and I'll get it for you.
See more than reporter, huh?
I thought we finished yesterday.
She wants another interview. Said to bring the plant with you.
Audrey's a new account.
Sorry, that's the right amount.
Daisy's only come in white.
Sir,
I'm too
worn out to fight.
Sorry, they're out of stock.
See, well, look. It's 6 o'clock.
Call back in the morning, can
you? Call back in the morning, won't you? Call back in the morning, thank you. Call back in the morning. What a day, what a day. Seymour, do you mind locking up for me?
Just a second, Audrey. I want to show you something.
I can't wait till tomorrow.
It'll only take a minute, I promise. So I thought I've been shopping around like you told me, and ta-da! What do you think?
Seymour!
Oh, you don't like it.
I don't know.
I'll take it off. I'll burn it, please. Just, oh, don't cry. Oh, no. Look what I've done. Audrey, I only bought it to impress you. It's all I've ever meant to do.
I don't know what's come over me. I'm just feeling a little under the weather lately.
It's Orin, isn't it? You've been down in the dumps ever since his mysterious disappearance. You miss him, don't you?
Miss him? Well, I've never been so relieved as when they told me he disappeared. It was like a miracle. Not to mention all the money I saved on Epsom salt and ice bandages.
Well, then what's the matter?
I feel guilty, I guess. If he met with some foul play or terrible accident of some kind, well, it's partially my fault, you see. Because secretly, I wished it.
Audrey, you shouldn't waste one more minute worrying about that creep. There are a lot of guys who would do anything to go out with you. Nice guys.
I don't deserve a nice guy, Seymour.
It's not true.
You don't know the half of it. I've led a terrible life.
Audrey, don't.
I deserve a creep like Orin. Yes. You know where I met him? In the gutter.
The gutter?
The gutter. It's a night spot. I worked there on our nights off when we weren't making much money. I put on cheap and tasteless outfits. Not nice ones like this. Low and nasty apparel, am I?
Audrey, it's all behind you now. Very nice person, and always knew you were. Underneath the bruises and the handcuffs. You know what I saw? A girl I respected. I still do. Lift up your head. Wash off your mascara. Here, take my Kleenex. Wipe that lipstick away. Show me your face. Clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly, Seymour is standing beside. Don't need no makeup. Don't have to pretend.
Why meet a man?
Strange afternoon, son. After my lawyer's appointment, I was called to the police station.
The police?
Yes. It seems they made a routine investigation into the disappearance of the motorcycle Tempest. And when they did, it seems they found a Mushnik Skid Row florist bag in his office.
Well, what's that supposed to mean?
Exactly what I asked myself, Seymour. And then I began to think about certain things I've noticed around here lately, like little red dots all over the linoleum.
I spilled Hawaiian punch in the stain.
Hard to keep things clean around here, isn't it? Especially when they only remove our garbage once a month.
What does that have to do with it? Hey, where are you going?
If you want something removed in a hurry on Skid Row, best not dispose of it here.
What are you talking about?
This.
I've got your number now.
I saw it last week and didn't think anything of it.
He knows just what you've done.
And the little red dot seemed innocent
you
enough.
You got no place to hide.
But then I catch you kissing the dentist.
Got nowhere to run.
And it begins to look like a lawyer.
He knows your life of crime.
Once he's out of the way, you move in, right?
I think it's a good time.
I'm innocent.
Then how do you explain this?
A picture of a baseball cap?
Your baseball cap. The police found it in Scribello's office and asked if I could identify it.
Did you?
No, they don't suspect you at all, Seymour, but they don't know about the little red dots, the uniform, the girlfriend.
I didn't do it.
Then come with
God
them to the police
straight. You know he's on your trail.
Just ease my conscience.
He's gonna turn you in.
Now, will you come?
They're gonna put you in jail.
Yeah, okay.
He's got the goods and I.
Okay, I'll move back up on the wall.
All set for supper time. Come on, think about all those offers. Come on, your future is all you. Come on, ain't no time to turn sweeping. Come on, I swear on all my scores, when he's gone, the world will be yours.
Okay, Seymour, let's go.
Don't you want to collect the days you see so you can deposit them in the morning?
Well, you put them in the safe, didn't you?
No.
One?
I forgot the combination.
It's thousands of dollars. Where is it?
In the plant.
In the plant?
I mean, that's the safest place, right? No thief will look in there.
The money's in the plant? So how am I supposed to get it?
Just knock.
Money? Money? The plane? Save up!
Igor! Can we have your autograph?
We saw you on Channel 5 News.
You look so handsome.
And you're gonna be so rich.
He's supposed to know.
Is it true Audrey Drew is wearing marching for the Rose Bowl?
Is it true the shop's decorating for the senior prom?
Yes, it's all true. Now please.
Hold on, Seymour. There's another big hotshot looking for you from uptown. He's been asking all over. Where can he find you? You're famous, Seymour.
Is that him?
That's him, Mr. Bernstein.
Thank you, girls. Seymour Krill.
Do I know you?
Of course not. But are you going to be happy when you do? Seymour, sweetheart, dollface, pussycat. Hey, Seymour Krill, aren't you Prince Hugh? My name is Bernstein, I'm with NBC. I came out here to convince you to do a weekly TV show for me. Seymour Krellborn's gardening tips for half an hour on Sundays at 4. TV's first home gardening program. Coming a mint and our ratings will soar.
I see the beach of inheritance, you know the book of life. It's not a question of merit, it's not a man of supply.
My darling, aren't you precious? Oh, you sweet, sweet thing. Beauty, sweetness, oh, baby doll. I'd like a word with your lover. Of course, you know me, I'm the editor's wife. We want your face on the cover of the December 3rd issue of Life. Yes, the front of Life magazine. That's an honor we so seldomly grant. We'll send someone by, let's say Thursday, for shots of you and your beautiful plants.
America's greatest and largest unidentified plant.
So, this is Seymour Krellborn. We've been looking all over for you, baby. Have your phones been busy? Did you get our telegram?
I don't think so.
Well, it's a good thing I came down in person then. Skip Snip, William Morris Agency. Forget the cable we sent you. It's nice to meet me, the pleasure is yours. Now let my firm represent you. We want to book you on lecturing tours, college campus rotary clubs, the kind of bookings my office can do. Show the plant, then talk, answer questions. It's educational lucrative too.
My future's starting, I've got to let it. Stick with this plant and gee, my bank account will thrive. What am I saying? No way, forget it. It's much too dangerous to keep that plant alive. I take these offers, that means more killing. Oh, new success would come with messy, nasty strings. I sign these contracts, that means I'm willing to keep on doing bloody, awful, evil things. No! No! There's only so far you can bend. No! No! This nightmare must come to an end. No! No! Seymour, old boy, do I need to be broken again, then unemployed. It's the only solution, it can't be avoided. The vegetable must be destroyed.
But then not like me. She might not want me. Without my plan, she might not love me anymore.
They say that meek shall inherit
when the
morning star
rises right on the line.
Cut the crap and bring on the meat.
Yeah, if only you'd eat meat. Only if you'd touch a mouse or flies, but no, you're so particular.
Come on, Crowborn, feed me. I ain't ate since Mushnick, and that was a week ago.
Look, just hold on one more night, okay? That's all I ask. Then, like, Magazine will be here in the morning, take our picture,
and then you'll find me somebody?
Then you'll never be hungry again. I promise.
Chow time, Crowborn. Food. Feed me food.
No, you're trying to be crazy. Just shut up, will you, for God's sake? Shut up.
Hold on. What's the matter with you?
It's the matter with me. Don't you think I know it needs food? Don't you think I know it'll die if I don't feed it soon? Don't you think I'm trying to think of some way, something, someone?
Seymour. You're hysterical. What's the big deal about a little plant food? I think running this place all by yourself is too much for you. Oh, when did Mr. Mushnick say he'd be back?
Huh?
You know, in that note you told me he wrote you, he was going to his sister's house and...
Czechoslovakia, right? Well, he could be gone for a very long time. Audrey, could I ask you something?
Anything.
Suppose there had never been an Audrey 2 and I was just nothing again. A nobody. Would you still like me?
I'd still love you, Seymour.
And it's settled.
What settled? A gun!
And bullets? And rat poison tomorrow morning? After Light Magazine gets here? You know who bites the dust?
Seymour!
Right, they'll snap the photo. We'll be famous. We'll take that TV job. We'll have a nice, quiet, normal life together. No more night beatings, no more squalling for blood.
What beatings? What blood? I don't get it, Seymour. Bullets, knives, rat poison. You're scaring me.
Look, there's nothing to be scared of. Look, we'll go away from here. I'll take that little development you've always dreamed about. We'll have a live a happily ever after. I promise. We'll have a nice little house, a nice little car. But no plans. We can't have any plans.
You're talking so peculiar, Seymour.
Look, I'll explain everything tomorrow. Just go home now, Audrey, please.
I can't leave you in this condition.
Don't worry about me. Don't worry about anything. Ouch!
Feed me.
I will not.
Feed me.
I said I will not, so stop asking.
Feed me.
You know what, fine. I'll run down the corner and pick you up a pound of rare roast beef. Maybe that'll hold you off till Light Magazine gets here.
No way.
Look, it's my last offer. Yes or no?
It's better than nothing.
Done. Fine. Great. Don't think you get dessert. Right.
as can be.
Is somebody in there?
You're looking mighty sweet.
Seymour? Seymour?
No, it ain't Seymour. It's me.
Oh my god!
Your friendly Audrey, too. This plant is talking to you.
I don't believe it.
Believe it, baby. It talks.
Am I dreaming this?
No, and you ain't in Kansas neither.
Something very wrong here.
Relax and go with it, doll. Do me a favor, will you, sweetheart? Come on and give me a drink.
Oh, I don't know if I should.
And little lady, be nice.
You just want water, right?
Or do I drink it straight?
Oh, your brand is dry, you
don't need no glass, no ice.
I'll get the can.
Don't need no twist of life.
Here you go.
And now it's supper time. Relax, sweetheart, it'll be easier. Come on, join Dennis when they push it. They're right inside.
Audrey? Audrey, no! No, get off her! Get off her! Audrey, oh, Audrey, are you alright?
Yeah? No.
Oh, Audrey! Oh, please don't die. Audrey, I need you. Please don't die.
The plant. It said the weirdest thing just now. It said that Orin and Mr. Mushnick were already inside.
It's true. It's all true. I fed them to it.
And that's what made it grow so big and strong and make you so famous.
Audrey, I've done terrible things. But not to you. Never to you.
But I want you to, Seymour.
What?
When I die, which should be very shortly, give me to the plant so it can grow and give you all the things that you deserve.
You don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, but I do. And if I'm in the plant, well, then I'm a part of the plant. So, in a way, we'll always be together. You'll wash my tender leaves. You'll smell my sweet perfume. You'll water me and care for me. You'll see me budding blue. I'm feeling strangely happy now, contented and serene.
Right in there, Mr. Martin.
Crowborn? Seymour Crowborn?
Leave me alone.
Patrick Martin, Licensing and Marketing Division. I've got a gilt-edged proposition for you, boy.
Not interested.
It's a very simple licensing deal. Let me explain in more detail. We take Leaf cuttings, develop little ivy tubes, and sell them to florists across the nation. Pretty soon, every household in America will have one. And we got a van out back at some pots. If you don't mind, we can start taking cuttings right now. Imagine, boy, Audrey 2's everywhere. With the right advertising, this could be bigger than hula hoops.
Bigger than hula hoops.
Much bigger.
Every household in America. Thousands of you eating. That's what you had in mind all along, isn't it?
No shit, Sherlock.
You're not talking about one hungry plant here. We're talking about world domination.
And I want to thank you.
You're a monster. And so am I.
Feed me.
You ain't the only thing I ever loved.
Too bad.
Take that.
Give up, cowboy.
Never. Rat poison. Eat it.
Give up, small fry.
Look, you may be tough on the outside, but there, on the inside, I'm gonna hack you to bits. Open up. Now!
Mr. Crowborn? Okay, girls. All I gotta do is snip some of the smaller leaves and replant them in those pots. Open the van, boys. We're ready to start voting.
Thank you.